What's up, fellas? What's
I'm
up,
good, bro.
world?
Eight.
It's another. Oh, R&B Reem already got started. I didn't even want to start.
Let's go at the head.
Another episode of the UncommonBond podcast coming at you. The four characters, we're missing two of our brothers, but they'll be here next week. But yo, we want to get started by just kind of like checking in, you know, mental health day, you know what I mean? Mental health month, you know, October, y'all know October is Unity Month, man.
October's a lot of fucking
who
months.
Named it? Wait, who named these people? Things?
Unity for who? This was
Unity for everybody, bro. So let's have some. Let's unite.
To determine that
UncommonBond podcast, man, coming at you. Yo, let's talk about let's make a quick, you know, roll call.
National Sons Day, National Daughters Day. Who determines all this shit? who is the governing body that determines these things?
Society, man. Society. That's bottom line. That's all I can say. Society. Yo, usual cast of characters. Yo, I'm MC on the mic. And we're about to get busy, but I want to introduce my man, bottom shelf, always got something on deck in the drinking department. Yo, bottom shelf, what's up, man? How you been? How's your week? How's your October? You united yet with anybody?
Nah, man. I'm the one man army. Yay, sword. I never been taken out. I keep these looking out. Yeah.
Drop size, like girls be dropping babies. Enough to make a new.
That is crazy. Peace.
Yo, how you doing?
Peace, ODB.
You good?
I'm good, man. I feel good. The weather's been sucky, but I heard it's going to get better, so.
Got another hat on.
Word. Another one. He said was about maybe like 50.
About 55.
Go like 56, 55.
Fucking Hattie McPatty.
Yo, who's that? Is that the Wizards?
This is the Washington Wizards, and just like last week, I don't give a damn about this team neither. colors.
That's it. That's
shout
all
out to Delvin Carter though. SIA Collective. That brother was on the morning show, The Breakfast Club, a while back, but he always pumping it out. A good African American entrepreneur selling all the dope clothes and sneakers and such. So support.
Yeah. I remember I was gonna when he first came on the scene, I was gonna buy a pair of sneakers, but I wasn't sure if I was gonna get my merchandise. That was like when it very first started. It
Word.
Was a couple years back.
It took a minute, but the shit is quality. SIA underscore collective.
Yeah, yeah, nah, definitely quality stuff.
So we're about to head to my man Picasso. Interesting shirt you decide to wear today, but So wait. We're gonna get into a topic we saw recently, but like, talk to us about your week. How you been? Talk to us. What's goody?
Yo, man, it's been a minute. My schedule's been kind of crazy lately, but I'm back for the people. Been a good. You know, I had my birthday last week.
That's sweet. Happy belated, brother.
Yeah, man. So. You know, I just kind of chilled out, man. I just wanted to do some light tourist, like-ish. So I just went to the city, went to a couple museums, you know what I mean? Like, just chilled out, like, you know.
Are you and Steph the same style?
Are you fancy, huh? Hmm?
Libra. That's right.
Yeah, he just missed it.
Oh.
Libra. Nah, he just missed whatever. He just missed the Libra scale, you know what I mean? He ain't balanced. You know what I mean? Gotta get balanced with the Libra skills, man. But nah, man, yeah, man, I've been chilling, man. Taking care of home, taking care of work, handling business, and just chilling, man.
Work facts. And we gonna take it back to the R&B Reem. What's up? Right.
Tonight I'm hip hop Reem. Shout out to the hip hop BET Awards.
What you listen to? Drop a gem on us real quick.
Drop a gem on it.
Gia's the only one that was up watching it with me. She was like, "Are there only rap people on here, Daddy?" Like I was like, "Yo, the R&B is in it. She's tight." She's like, "There's only rappers up here. What the fuck?"
You know what's crazy? She was nowhere near being born when some of them rappers was like, "Hey, right?" It's crazy. I like
at all.
Time.
Not
Time just goes by, man.
Nah, that's a Fendi fact, man. I'm chilling, bro. I'm another week. Every week is a fucking surprise for me. So I just keep it going, man, and try to stay focused. And just,
all right. So yo, we got a we got, first of all, I wanna point out a few things before we truly get started. A lot of things been happening, you know, in the past couple weeks. Yo, shout out to, I'm not a Mets fan. I'm not a Yankee fan, I'm a Mets fan, but shout out to Aaron Judge. You know, got 62 today. I mean,
did they win?
One could say he's the true home run king. That's what people say. Wait, Picasso, I know you. That's why I look to you. Because I know you have a different opinion. But one could say, they've been saying that he is the true home run king now with 62. You know what I'm saying? So, you know, I'm sure you have your own person who's a home run king. So, right? Barry Bonds, right? Right? We're going to say Barry Bonds.
It's the fact.
All right, cool. All right, but shout out to Aaron Judge. He got number 62 today. Yo, and then the other piece that we want to, you know, address, man, you know, it's, as, you know, Bottom Show said, it's been a lot of rain, but we haven't tasted anything that's been happening in Florida, man. So, shout out to the people in Florida. You know, Hurricane Ian is really doing a number out there, man.
Fort Myers, you know what I mean? That got ravaged, man.
Yeah, I don't know if y'all got people's family, friends out there who was affected by it, but man, shout out to those people. Hope that everything, you know what I mean, worked out and, you know, they're able to recover from it. Because this little rain that we've been getting for the past 2 days, I'm like, yo, I can't deal with it.
It's annoying.
So I can't even imagine what it's like to have your flooded. And, you know what I mean? People are like swimming, bro, in their basements and all that. You know what I mean? So, shout out to people out in Florida. You know, we send a free out to y'all.
Let me give a quick shout out, MC. Shout out to, and rest in peace to Tommy Bailey, young brother I grew up with. Only had me by like 2 years, but we played baseball together with Latin Souls in Brooklyn. But he was killed on a train this past week. Very unfortunate. This past Friday, he was killed on a train. Got stabbed in the neck with a knife in Brooklyn. But everybody on the train got a knife, man. Like, it's crazy out here, man. And any day could be your last in this concrete jungle. And it's you know. So I think when you say that, I think of people going through unfortunate things. And I just, you know, pops to my mind. So I just want to say rest in peace and shout out to Tommy Bailey. He was a real good dude. Humble, gentle giant, and R.I.P. to him.
R.I.P. R.I.P. Yeah. All right, man. We gonna jump right into it, man. I commented on Picasso's shirt, man. Black Fathers Matter, man. But Kanye West has something similar, bro. He has something similar this past week, so. Let me hear y'all opinion on it, man. White, we got a black man who's influential in this world, billionaire. You know, he corrected. He's not a billionaire. 11. Let me 11 or whatever he's up to at this point. Wearing a White Lives Matter shirt, man. I mean, does that bring up any type of emotions with y'all, or you know, it is what it is type of deal? He's just looking for the attention.
It's Kanye. It's what he does.
But what is he? What does Kanye do? I mean, he affects the culture, man. So, what does that wearing a shirt like that symbolize to us, or you know, black men, or just
what does wearing a Black Lives Matter shirt symbolize to us?
True.
Nothing. It's a fucking organization that is that fucked question us dry. Every fucking minute.
Pimped us. And sold us on the corner.
Yeah, bro. Like, I'm gonna be real with you. I just don't give a fuck, man. Cause Kanye, the way I look at Kanye is, man, like, this nigga stood up to Adidas. He stood up to the Gap. Like, he stood up against a billion-dollar corporations, right? So I'm not saying I'm waiting for what he, like, what's the purpose of it. The way I look at it is like, yo, white lives matter, black lives matter. It's just a saying. What the fuck did Black Lives Matter do for black people? Because the people that run that organization is like the church, like Bishop, what you call it? What the nigga got a whole closet full of Gucci and Fendi, nigga. Like,
but I know, you know, it's, we're saying it is what it is, but is it really it is what it is? I mean, because the whole Black Lives Matter movement, people were going.
No, I'm not saying it is what it is. I'm saying it, the Black Lives Matter movement ain't shit. So what's wrong with him? What you think the White Lives Matter movement go? It ain't a movement. It's just a shirt. And he's showing how much that phrase means nothing.
Yeah, but Reem, it's not just a shirt, because if you wear the shirt, it's just a shirt. You talk about an influential person wearing that shirt that everyone is, you know, I mean, people going to go out and buy the shirt, or people are going to talk about it the way we're talking. What does it symbolize? Is that his way of saying that whole Black Lives Matter, White Lives Matter? He might wear another shirt tomorrow that says Latin Lives Matter. Like, does it really,
exactly,
really matter? That's what I'm saying.
Means nothing. It's a blip.
So I say, like, you have to understand the power of media and attention. Or media attention, rather. Like, so, like, until you do that, you know, it's like, everything will seem like a form of malice or something, like, where for somebody to draw opinion and hate on them. Like, I don't know what his purpose was, but there's been times where things happen, and I think we always quick to rush the judge, and I'm not giving him no pass at all. Because, you know, white lives has only mattered in this country from the creation to it, you know, till now. But, you know, when things like that happen, when you put in the word white and you do Black Lives Matter, I think like this. I say, like, Dr. Francis Cress Wilson said, you know, if you don't understand racism, white supremacy, what it is and how it works, everything else you think you understand will only confuse you. So what's the make of this shirt? It got everybody talking about it. It got everybody talking about him. You know, nobody was talking about Kanye music. Mm-hmm. Nobody's talking about Candace Owens. You know what I mean? White Lives Matter. You know, her white husband, I'm sure he appreciated that shirt.
Let me ask you a question, Steph. Like, I'm looking at Picasso's shirt, right? Black Fathers Matter. What happens if you're walking down the block, you see a black person wearing a shirt that says White Fathers Matter? Like, would that spark up an emotion in you? Would you think that person is making a mockery? What would be your thought process seeing that?
I'm gonna say this, right? That if I saw that, it'd be like another shirt at this point. But there was a flashpoint, and I remember during the pandemic when it was like emotions were really, really high. And I was doing like side jobs for Amazon and in PA, this is like Trump country. And I saw a lot of Blue Lives Matter flags.
He ain't win. How the fuck is this country? He ain't win PA.
I know. It's crazy though, but he got a lot of support out here.
Nah, he does. I'm fucking with
you. And he, there were so many flags that said Blue Lives Matter, and that was triggering. You know what I mean? Because that was like a purposeful dagger at the movement at the time. Although we should have known but didn't know that the whole time the Black Lives Matter movement was just, you know, for coin anyway. You know what I mean? But the Blue Lives Matter, that triggered me. But this shirt, I'm of the ilk of, I'm going to support Kanye without supporting Kanye. I ain't buying no sneakers. I ain't buying nothing that this man make. But I do understand that this black man lost his mother and he's never been the same since. For that reason alone, I will always have a spot for his redemption at some point. But he is lost and he's trying to figure it out. And I wish him well, but I don't gotta support nothing about him.
But so then you do. So technically, it does mean something to you because you're looking at it as he's lost.
Yeah, he's lost. I feel. You know what I mean? Personally, I do feel.
But like that's what I'm saying. Like, I think Kanye, you know, I don't believe he's that lost. I do believe he has a lot of trauma with the death of his mom. Because if you watch that show,
right,
documentary,
yes,
like I'm gonna be real with you, his connection with his mom is like, and I thought I was, but I think
that shit is different.
You know, like my mom wouldn't even know where to start to understand me, like rapping and all of
Yo,
that.
Yo,
know?
She was reciting his rhymes, right. Bro.
So
I looked at that shit and I was jealous.
Like, yeah, I definitely could see they had the crazy bond, right. But I don't think that's what it is. I think I'm gonna be real. It's to me like it's I feel business. Kanye exposes like. Not the truth. I don't want to say the truth, but he just exposed that, like, the trends. So it's trendy right. to say, yo, I'm going with Black Lives Matter. It's trendy to say I don't like Trump. You know, it's just fucking trendy.
Right.
You feel me? And that's why I think, like, Kanye does it. And Kanye's showing us that, like, yo, at the end of the day, all right, Black Lives Matter, what did that movement do? You know, like, there's yes. more... little local organizations on a regular platform that's able to do more for the community than Black Lives Matter. So I don't think Kanye is trying to tell us that we're all one, that he's saying that, oh, all lives matter. And I don't think he's on it like that. I think he's proven a point that this is bullshit.
Right.
And we need to do what we do, like what he's doing. He didn't have to stand up to fucking Adidas. He did that. He ain't have to stand up the Gap. He did that. And I'm telling you right now, it's all about, I believe that's the point that he's trying to make.
He's as crazy as a fox.
But let me ask you a question. But Picasso, Black Lives Matter, did it make an impression on society or was
so,
it? Just
so Black Lives Matter, we all must know and understand by now, there are Black Lives Matter, the organization, and then there's Black Lives Matter, the phrase, okay? I don't think many people who I know support Black Lives Matter, the organization.
Thanks.
But I definitely support Black Lives Matter, the phrase.
Right.
You know, there was a point in time, and to bring it back to, does the shirt matter? Yes, the shirt matters. And I'm going to tell you why it mattered. Because there was a time where somebody was wearing a red hat with white writing on it. You look to see if it said make America great again. You would have been like, oh shit, you gotta make America great again hat. And that's why when I made the hat, make America pay reparations, and plenty of people would stop and look at me until they read the hat because it was it the
symbolize
optics,
something, right? Symbolize.
Ooh, that hat mattered. Used to get me in some shit, boy.
The hat mattered. Yeah, that hat used to get you in shit too, right? You know what I'm saying? So yeah, it does matter. And I think my vision of this is just like how you know how like right now we're desensitized to death, to killings, to all the things we see on social media. We are very desensitized to a lot of things. Now, this may be the same way how people are going to, you know, you start the trend of people being desensitized to a hat, to a shirt. You know, like, this may be the start of that. And that's the only logic I can see behind it right now. But, you know, this will start to where people are like, ah, it's just a shirt. Just like now, you see somebody get killed on your phone on Instagram, shot dead, and then it's like, oh damn, that's fucked up, and you just keep moving.
I mean, I hear what y'all saying. I just think that you know, we all, especially him, you know, he has a lot of influence. You know what I'm saying? And so you're talking about, you know, yes, he's not a sports player. You know, like they have like the biggest influence on certain things, but like. He is Kanye West. And I'm thinking like, if a black person were to buy that shirt and wear it, would they get bullied? Would they get beat up? Would they get, you know what I'm saying, you know, chastised for wearing that because he decided? I think you got to be mindful, bro, of the type of stuff that's even on a shirt, right? Like, I mean, because at the end of the day, you know, Picasso, I don't see you, and I've known you for years. I don't see you wearing a shirt that says white fathers matter.
Well, white fathers matter. Well, like this, so with white lives matter, that's not a lie.
No,
it's the truth of this country. White lives has only mattered in this country.
No, I get that. But what I'm saying is, would you ever wear a shirt that says white fathers matter?
I'm not a white father, so that's why I wouldn't wear
it. But that's my point. He's not a white man. So when he says white lives matter, like, what is he implying? You know what I'm saying?
I'm going to tell you what he's implying. Business, nigga. We talking about it.
He has a lot of white friends.
It's business. Good job, Kanye.
Kanye don't need us.
That's a fact. You're right. But we helping him. One more pair of Yeezys.
That nigga sells sneakers out in like 0.5 seconds, bro. He don't need
plastic.
I think this is the holes in them.
Is Kim K? Hey, hold on. Is the Kardashians white or black?
They are fucking from a country called, what is it? Armenia.
So the European?
White.
Is that European?
I don't know where Armenia is. I believe it's in Europe.
So.
No, don't quote me. I don't know.
Right, I believe you're right. Though I believe you're right.
I think he's right.
Yeah, I believe you're right. But Europeans that come to this country, you know, all these Europeans that's here, they're white. They're the white descendants of Europeans who was colonizers. So they're white. So the Kardashians are white. So white lives matter to him because he's fucking. He got kids by.
Is in Asia. Armenia's in Asia.
Asia.
Yeah.
Listen, I get it. You know what I mean?
That ain't white.
I think it is what it is.
Ain't white.
I just think that
it's not.
I just think that he represents a part of the culture, and you know, that shirt might send the wrong message. But you know, it is what it is, and you know, anyone could do what they want to do. But you know, I think it does send a message that could be misconstrued by both white and black people, you know what I'm saying? So,
Gucci Rap famously said, "Shit ain't never gonna change. Fuck it."
Well, yeah. The fact that he was standing there with Candace Owens was an issue.
Now that is a bigger statement than the fucking shirt.
That is a bigger issue for me than the shirt.
But I'm tired of this nigga, man. What else we gonna talk about?
All right, yo, man. So let's move forward, man. Let's kind of stay in the same community.
Oh shit.
The yo, white community?
Nah, in the community of the Kardashians in some weird odd way. So yo, recently, man, you know, on you know Shannon Sharp's show, he had Lamar Odom on.
Shay Sharp.
Shay Shay.
Aside from Lamar Odom talking about Kobe.
Get my black
mouth. Kobe Bryant did something to his neck while he was sleeping. Whatever. I'm gonna leave that one alone.
We should leave the whole Lamar Odom conversation.
Nah, I want to talk about it because he says something that I want to get.
My nigga Judge Joe Brown said, "You sound like a crackhead."
What Stephen A. said? Lamar Odom, who's on crack?
Nah, but he said, you know, Khloe, Triston, the whole ordeal, they were dating, and obviously, and Lamar and Khloe was dating at one point.
I thought this but, couldn't get anywhere.
You know, nah, but Khloe wanted to have another baby, but she wanted, you know, obviously his sperm, right?
Because whose sperm?
Triston. So she wanted to keep it in the family, right? She wanted to have two kids, I guess, quote unquote, by the same dad. But at the same time, he's doing his thing. So Lamar was like, yo, why is it that she allowed that to occur, you know, knowing that dude don't want to participate in raising his kids, so to speak. So talk to me about that idea. I mean, y'all, what do you feel about? I got to tell you something. I met someone who once told me something like that. Like she... You know, she were to have another kid, she would like to have it with her kid's father, who they were no longer together. You know what I mean? And that was like, really? You know, but obviously not the traditional way, you know what I mean? Of sex.
Yeah, she don't want to be a statistic.
Well, you can say that, right? But what's your would you guys be okay if you meet a woman and she's like, she has a kid already and she tells you, look.
As long as it ain't me, do your thing, baby doll.
Yeah, come on. Bottom shelf, yo.
Don't ask bottom shelf, because he's not there.
Yeah, I can't ask
you. I'm on one tonight, baby. Let's have this conversation.
Woo! So, let me go. Let me treat you like a class. Let me come back to you on that one. You know, phone a friend. Phone a friend, bottom shelf. But I'm a phone one for you. Picasso, what's your vision on it? What's the ideal about that? Do you agree with that? That she wants to have a kid, keeping this in the family, even though dude don't want to be a part of it?
No. Stupid. Some things don't need long explanations. No.
But what's wrong with it? What's wrong with her wanting her, you know, to have two kids by the same, so that, you know what? Her daughter can say, you know, that's my true brother. That's my real brother and sister. We got the same mom. We got the same dad.
Okay, people have, I answer this. People have kids by different men. Or men have kids by different women all the time. This is not abnormal. So when she say, "Oh, I want this," people need to separate wants and needs. Okay, you want another kid, cool. And all right, you want to have another kid, but what you need is you need a father to be actively in that child's life. You need a father to raise that kid. You need a father to teach that child things. You need a father. So she's putting her ego in what she wants before what's needed. And so that's the only way I think I can answer that is, you know, these are first world problems. You know, she got money. She could take care of a kid, but and that just also goes to show that no matter how much money you got, you know, kids still need their fathers.
Mm-hmm. Reem, what's your opinion on that? I know you're big on, you know, you have a stance on fatherhood and parenthood. What's your vibe about that?
I hope to one day understand the logic of what Cash just said as far as the first world people.
First world problems.
It's definitely rich people shit. Cause I'm gonna be real with you. Oh, that's fire. They Mobb Deep is on right now. That's crazy. It's not a big deal to me because the way I look at it is this, right? Like, this was like, she did it because she had the money. It costs a lot. It takes a lot of money to fucking get somebody to walk around with your kid for you. Steph, get the fuck off the fake phone call. Yo, this thing is crazy. Yo, two, the father's going to be in the kid's life. Are they going to live together? Not at all. So did she already deal her kid a bad hand where, like, she didn't give her kid a chance to have a mommy and daddy household? For sure. That's 100%. But that dude, Triston, going to be in the kid's life. Why? One, if he wants to build a brand, he knows he's going to do it. Because
he got nothing else to do.
The Kardashians, he's not doing good in basketball. The Kardashians,
he sucks. He's fucking garbage.
Like, they up. They the ones that are up right now. So you do right by a Kardashian as far as their kid. You get invited to Kris Jenner's annual Christmas party.
Kris Jenner's a geek.
Wait, hold on.
Doing all right in life.
And we just witnessed Kanye go through this with Kim K, right?
Kanye,
he wasn't allowed to the party.
He fucked up, man.
He wasn't allowed here, or he wasn't allowed to do this. So that assumption that he's going to be in a life, that's not, you're assuming that. Because
allowed. Let me ask you a real question.
She could cut. Let me ask you a real question.
Let me ask you a question. You and your wife, God forbid, y'all break up. Can she allow you to not be at your kid's event?
One, we not rich. Okay, so these are rich people problems.
Take the money. Oh, so you're basically saying without, you ain't got much to lose. You saying like, you'll take it there. That's my point. Because the way I look at it is like this. All that loud shit, fuck it. Yo, you know what? The kids is, my logic is this. They didn't let Kanye into the party. Kanye chose to make a big deal out of it. Because at the end of the day, the nigga had another shorty anyway. So you know what? Guess what you need to do, Ye? Your rich ass need to go throw. They have fucking Blue's Clues. You need to fucking go hire Disney to come to your crib and make it even better. And now your daughter got two fucking parties out
there. I said that before. When, listen, if y'all go back to the tape, there was an episode where we kind of went over this. we went down this road, and I said that same thing. And I think it was you, Reem, who said, "Nah." You said something about
I supported him moving over there.
You supported him moving. I'm like, you can just get your house over here and throw your own party.
I was against talking about.
Yeah, I supported that.
But now you saying
I wanted him. I wanted him to move across the street.
Yeah, right. But now you saying he can have his own party over here. Party. That's what I was saying before.
No, you're saying basically he shouldn't have moved over there.
Because he could have a house anywhere he wants to, because he has the money to buy it, and he can throw a party for his daughter there.
Yeah, but that has nothing to do with me. I agree that I don't knock him moving over there for the purpose of like, yo, whatever this little gated community they got up in Calabasas, I'm going to be close to my kid when I'm in Calabasas. But as far as like,
bro, how we go back to Kanye, man?
He was not allowed. And Triston. If she gets a restraining order, then that's
a whole thing. About Triston.
Because nobody cares about Triston. See,
Kanye is that Triston, powerful. Man. I don't care about Triston. I just wanted to talk about that topic.
It went back because it was talking about what was allowed to happen and how a woman could not allow you to be in your kid's life if she is the custodial parent. She could do things and not allow you.
Put it like this. There's women.
But why does a really woman have to be the custodial parent?
I'm just talking about in this case, she would be the custodial parent.
Look,
the thing is, there are women. What Khloe did, she did it because she can. Her child is not going to want for anything. She's not going to need anything from that man. So at the end of the day, listen. She had a child. She wanted another kid for a kid that she already had. I'm going to keep it 100 with you. I don't knock her for wanting to have a fucking another kid with the same dad. Fuck it. At the end of the day, it is what it is.
That's a want. That's not a need.
No, but who the fuck does everything for a need in this life? Did you need that Black Fathers Matter shirt?
About when you're doing things for a child, when you're doing something, when you're bringing a child in the world, that's Max. What you need is Max. Something you want to think about.
Nah, when the
loving when you was buy good, the shirt, that's a when, want. That's when something the loving you could was want. Good. You could want a shirt.
When the loving was good, it was a want. Nobody needs a kid. You want your child. You understand what I'm saying? There's nobody that needs a kid.
Right. So she wants a child, but the child needs a father.
No, you don't.
You don't need a father.
You don't.
That's a topic within itself.
I'm gonna tell you, that's a hot take right there. Look at all the people. Look, mostly statistics to show most of the people in prison, most of the people who are homeless, most of the people who commit suicide don't have fathers or have fatherless fathers. That the statistics to show that fathers are much more needed than they are not needed. That's all I'm saying.
I hear you. But at the end of the day, I listen to people like Steph's story. I listen to, you know, somewhat of mine. At the end of the day, whatever obstacles that I've been through in life, I don't feel I would have not been there had I not had a dad. Do I appreciate being a great father? I appreciate it because I love my kids. But as far as like saying that, like, a father is necessary. I don't believe it's necessary.
Is a mother necessary?
Huh?
Just to have the baby. That's
is a mother necessary?
Just to have the baby. You got to carry the baby.
It's not about which parent is necessary.
No,
about,
because we're talking about...
If the mom is not there, you necessary.
You got to have the baby.
Know, are mothers necessary?
If the mom is not... I'm looking at it like this. If the mom is not there, that doesn't mean the mother is necessary. The mother is just absent. If the dad is not there, that doesn't mean the dad is necessary. The dad is just absent. I do believe... Whoever the parent is going to be able to do it. A great parent is going to be able to hold it down regardless.
But that was the question is.
No, I gave you my answer. I know what the question was, and I told you.
Because we heard fathers are not necessary.
Right.
And so are mothers necessary or not?
I just said it.
No, you said something about absent.
What would a father have to be needed? Present or absent?
I just want
to
know.
Just answer that question. Needed. What would well, a father need to not? Be needed? Why would a father need to be needed? Because he's not there, right?
So if a father's not needed, then a mother's not needed.
Whatever
parent they're both parents.
Is holding it down, that other parent is not necessarily needed. Did you raise your daughter? Hold on. Did you raise your daughter with her mother there? Or you did a good job without her?
I did a good job without her.
Thank you.
However,
that was my point.
However, you know why it's needed? Because the child will want and need to have that sense of connection with their parent. So does she still talk to her mother? Yes, because she needs that relationship. It's not like her mother's dead.
No, I'm saying it's not needed though.
Where she can't have that relationship, but a child is gonna be necessary for that child to have that relationship.
I hear you, and I'm not trying to go back and forth.
Right, right, right.
We're not guaranteed to be here.
Right.
So if we're not here on the physical, that means what are you saying? Like a parent is not needed. It's helpful. It works. It's beneficial, but I don't think it's a necessity.
I would say
a strong.
You know what? That I mean, I think we should. We got to get the whole.
That's a discussion. That is a real discussion.
Let's table that.
Yeah,
that's a real discussion.
We got to get the whole crew for that one.
Baby. That's a real discussion.
Nah, we
fathers are needed. I just want to state that for the record. Fathers are needed for the record.
Fuck them niggas. They don't want to be here. Fuck. We rocking with what's here right now. Fuck them niggas.
Listen,
I love you, Greg.
Except for
I love you, AG.
Listen, they being fathers right now. They need it right now, so I ain't mad at them.
AG,
we apologize, but Gorgeous, you officially fucking David Ruffin.
Go ahead, man.
Yo, on that note, man, let's talk about what's in y'all cups, man. Let's. But we got to table that piece, man. That right there is a really good topic, man, that we could really dive into and get some information. What y'all drinking, man? I just finished the bottle, B. I mean, I just finished this Appleton Estate. I don't even say, I think Picasso may have brought this to the crib, but
no, that was mine. You finished his.
Oh, my bad. Yeah, so
you alcoholic. You finished them both.
How you just finished both two bottles of fucking gifts?
Nobody
finishes the gift liquor.
I don't look a gift horse in the mouth, brother. Bottom shelf, what you got over? What you got cooking up over there?
Hey, yo, shout out to ASAP Rocky, Rihanna's hubby. This is the Canadian whiskey, Mercer Prince. It's not bad, man. And it comes with not one, but two shot glasses. I ain't taking this one. You know what I mean? And I'm also having a French connection.
Wait, bottom shelf, if they want that in the store, how much is going to run them?
Oh, shit. We got to go to the top shelf, baby. no, this is about, I want to say it's like 39. I could be wrong. It's been a while.
Oh, you fancy today.
Hello. But yeah, and French Connection, any cognac you want with Amaretto. So tonight I'm fucking with Lozio. I don't know what this is, but it's really good. I love French Connections. And shout out to Lloyd's Carrot Cake. This is best carrot cake in NY.
Nah, they shit is fire.
Lloyd's, Lord have mercy, Lloyd's. I love you, baby.
Tell them niggas they could do a little restructuring of the fucking, like, you know, like.
This is true. This is true.
They just need take to... our money and just say, fuck it. We gonna keep it.
Word. They just throw that joint in the box and they keep it moving, B. They out here moving. They moving carrot cake what's... like weight.
Casa, what's in your cup, buddy?
Yo, it's welcome to October. And I don't normally drink beer, but this is Oktoberfest.
Shiver me timbers.
It's that weather. The weather has broken. The heat is officially cut on. That's another conversation we need to table that.
Yeah, another one.
The heat come on.
The heat comes on when winter starts, December
23rd. Cuffing season.
We gotta table that conversation.
It's gonna be 78 degrees on Thursday.
It's definitely gonna be a nice day on Thursday.
Yo, we turned it on, we could turn it back off.
That's right.
It costs more money to do that.
You know it don't.
Yes, it does.
Valid.
Who you fucking with, electric or gas?
No, that's why Reem right now, look what Reem is wearing. He's wearing jump joint. He wears
Tom Claus.
Put on your clothes.
Yo, Reem, what you got in your cup, bro?
Yo, I ain't never going to change, man. I never change. This is Reem every day. You heard Tito
Puente.
You know what I'm saying? It's gluten-free. No cows. You heard Tito with that seltzer. No juice, no sugar, and we good to go, baby.
Yo, Oktoberfest up in White Plains this Sunday, right?
This Sunday from 1 to 6. I ain't German, but hey, fuck it, I'm a representative.
Black Lives Matter.
Yo, I throw on a Black Lives Matter shirt.
But real quick, man, because we in the Oktoberfest, be like, what beer, of all beers to beer, what y'all like?
Oh, man, this is easy for me. Killigan's Red. Killigan's Irish Red is my beer. Killigan's. All day, every day.
I'm a Modelo guy.
Yeah, I'm Stella all the way, man. I'm Stella all the way, Stella B.
You know what's crazy? Like, I feel like the older I've gotten, right? I like I've been fucking with these IPAs, man. Like
IPAs is
I didn't know I liked it. But
me neither.
I've never been a beer guy, so I've never taken the time to say, all right, let me try different ones. But you go to the bar, you know, because that's my vibe. My vibe is go to the bar, shout out to Lazy Boy Lagoon, go there, tequila lime wings, and two Brooklyn Lagers and some IPA joints. You understand what I'm saying?
Hello. Talk to
him. Nice.
So I don't have a favorite beer. I don't have one. I'm going to be real with you.
All right. French Connection.
Yo, shout out to Oktoberfest, man. But we gonna end real quick, man. I saw something today on IG, and I was like, you know what? I know we've watched a ton of black movies. So I'm gonna ask y'all a question to end this joint, right? Which character was the hardest? We have Old Dog. Old Dog, Menace to Society. We have Doughboy, Boys in the Hood. Okay. We got Nino Brown, New Jack. We got Bishop Juice. Which character you riding with if you need somebody to hold you down?
I ain't fucking with Bishop because he'll shoot me. Bishop had no loyalty at all.
So you're doing process elimination. Go ahead.
Yeah, I'm not fucking with Bishop because that nigga turning on everybody. I know you said Nino Brown and who are the other two?
Nino Brown, Doughboy, and Old Dog.
Oh, I'm fucking with Old Dog, my nigga. He loyal.
I'm fucking with Old. Doughboy was too soft. You know, Dough got soft on us.
Facts.
Bishop, he was disloyal. Yeah, he was just too
fuck with nobody but Bishop.
And Nino, come on, Nino wasn't no gangster. That nigga was a snitch. He told on
Rodimans, he shooting everybody.
He told on Kareem.
Old Dog, give me Lorenz Tate.
Who you going with, MC?
Yo, I'm going old school, man. I gotta go to my man Nino Brown, bro. Like, I gotta go Nino Brown, bro. From the style to Jesus. He just holds you down. I'm going Nino Brown, man.
What? Yo, let me tell you something.
His brother's keeper.
And he killed G Money, man. Come on, I can't
Facts,
go with that.
Me.
I can't go
he
with
killed
him,
his
man.
Brother, man.
He killed his brother. Money, over what? I'm going with Old Dog. Old Dog, motherfucking came over there, helped him stomp this motherfucker out. You know what I mean? Old Dog was like, yo.
Yo,
said, can you suck my what?
Bro, I gotta tell you, one of the best
scenes. Then he was trying to look. Then he said, yo, y'all want some cheeseburgers?
Yo, when the best scene in that movie is when Kane saw Jada Pinkett's character over there, dude is rocking with him. He said, oh, you strapped? He's like, yeah. Like,
what you want to do?
I mean,
no, he said, you know it.
The old dog represented, but yeah, I gotta go with my man Nino Brown, man.
Yucky
dog.
Yeah.
My nigga say, you know it. Yo, he was playing cards. He like this, you know it.
Like, it ain't nothing but a thing.
Come on, son.
No, man. Man. Once again, we got a great show, man. We locked it down. We miss out two brothers.
Gorgeous. You kicked out
the them niggas.
Wait, hold on. We got daddy. Another thing.
Sleeping ass niggas.
Yo.
Fuck out of here.
I'm going to say one word.
Kid.
One word. Dama.
I'm not saying that word at all.
Now what?
I'm lost.
Dama.
You're
not talking about Jeffrey Dahmer.
No. Yeah.
When I was small, they used to tease me because my hair was teasy, hard and greasy. But now I'm living well like George and Wheezy. So easy.
What?
Does it? Yo. Is it? Because I'm rocking beats, beats, beats. Boom and chewing because I'm doing what just have to be done. Now we in there like swimwear. Cause call on me, hun. Give me hugs, little peck. Put your tongue, lock your sex. Love respects to my bros that live on 560 Street.
Right.
Smashing monster, mashing, boom, bashing in a fashion, which is wild. Now I smile when I whip, flash and seize with my style. Call me cuckoo, I'm making boo-coo bucks. I'm getting fully prepared to tear all empty that are smucks. For bros who sleeping down the deep pool, as I soothe in the groove, cause I'm smooth like Mr. Vork. Doobly zoo, Mr. Woo. No need to be rude, but F you, cause I ain't got nothing to prove.
Flash move, yo, we don't got nothing to prove. Flash move, yo, we don't got nothing to prove. Flash move, yo, we don't got nothing to prove. Flash move, yo, we don't got nothing to prove.
Even the Beaver, Arriva, Dirt Cheap, Heavens to Mercy, Faithful, Sayana, Adios, Muchachos, Dami, who I'm rocking my boots, they too. Mr. Chippoos, I'm about to wreck shop with a doodle chop, a doodle chop, a doodle chop, chop. Yo, Cisco, with the nonsense, I'm Dick Sosa. Take a look at the super fly, Big Jimmy, the honey, the chip, yo, Weaver, sugar by sugar. I ask what he answers, all what he has, my lyrics are never done. For the big jaw, Emma, who Emma, the fun, I'm running the butt, light stun. Come light to lashes, with a witness, fuck a bacchus, my witness. Ask the tongue about my tongue and the style that I brung instead. I'm the alley, rabble, goody bank, and shiver, jibber, dabble, drop over the red tent, and bumble red. These lyrics are come old, Tommy, Ed, bumble red. Mr. Chippoos, gonna say, dread, 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 dread. You said I'm gonna rock, but a redirect shot on the top pop. I get props, I pick up the mic, jump, stun, the bus, on the MC's dog, drop, stun, my accent. You're mocking my clothes, you're clocking, ripping MC's to smith, the reason the ribbity, bibbity, long stocking. So don't step to tip, I'm on the last move tip. You'll say, grab, try, ready, but again, and plus, he yank my babble ship. So, ooh, chit chit, wobble up this kit. Rip it if it's specific, don't get a riff when I kicks it. Chitty, chitty, bang, man, pepper the pew, pepper the pew. Last move, your eye ain't got nothing to prove.
Last move.